After the release of Blender 4.2, the current latest version, the developers of Blender have added a few new features, which can help speed up your UV unwrapping workflow. First one we're going to be talking about is Edge Slide. If you're familiar with modeling in Blender, if I press 2 on the keyboard to go into Edge Select mode here, and select one of my edges in the 3D viewport, and press G twice, you can see I can slide an edge like this. This works with vertexes as well, if I press 1 on the keyboard and press G twice. So this is now a feature that we can use inside of the UV editor too, which is something which I was actually hoping they would have for a while. So I'm going to press 2 on the keyboard to go into Edge Select mode in my UV editor, and I'll select one of my edges, and I can press G twice. And you can see this makes things really easy to make some small adjustments. My favorite new feature though is the overlapping UV islands feature. Yes, I know in the last video I talked about how overlapping UV islands is typically a bad thing. However, there are some cases where identical UV islands you might want to overlap. For example, if I was going to texture paint this cylinder here, and I wanted the top and the bottom to be identical, then I would want these two faces to be on top of each other, so I'd only have to paint it once. This would be true especially if I was going to paint mainly in this workspace here, using the image editor workspace. So what I'm going to do is, if we remember, we can press L to select a linked island, and you'll notice here that it's going to select more than usual, and that's because we have these arrows turned on still. So we can just turn off these arrows and just press A to select everything in this menu here so we can see everything. Then I'll press L again in my UV editor to select just that one face. Then I can press G to move it. And if I want to overlap these, I can just press B, and you can just select one of the vertexes on your island, which you're going to want to line up. So I'll choose this one here, and then we can just line it up with this vertex here. And now you can see we've easily overlapped our islands with just that quick command. Of course, we could use this magnet as well. However, this new B command is much quicker and easier since there's less settings to set up. And yeah, that's about it. Thought I would quickly update you guys on what new features have been added to the UV editor. If you want to learn more about UV unwrapping, I've got plenty of tutorials here which you can check out, starting from the fundamentals and working our way up. In the next video, I'm going to be covering some more UV tips which are not new to the current Blender version, but are still pretty handy to know nonetheless. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.